step to Christ, rejoicing in the Lord. In his Sermon on the Mount, Christ taught his disciples precious lessons in regard to the necessity of trusting in God. Those lessons were designed to encourage the children of God through all ages, and they have come down to our time full of instruction and comfort. The Savior pointed his followers to the birds of the air as they warbled their carols of praise, unencumbered with thoughts of care, for they sow not, neither do they reap. And yet the great Father provides for their needs. The Savior asked, "Are ye not much better than they?" Matthew 6, verse 26. The great provider for men and beasts opens his hand and supplies all his creatures. The birds of the air are not beneath his notice. He does not drop the food into their bills, but he makes provision for their needs. They must gather the grains he has scattered for them. They must prepare the material for their little nests. They must feed their young. They go forth singing to their labor, for your heavenly Father feedeth them. And are ye not much better than they? Are not you, as intelligent spiritual worshippers, of more value than the birds of the air? Will not the author of our being, the preserver of our life, the one who formed us in his own divine image, provide for our necessities if we but trust in him? Christ pointed his disciples to the flowers of the field, growing in rich profusion and glowing in the simple beauty which the Heavenly Father had given them as an expression of his love to men. He said, "Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow." The beauty and simplicity of these natural flowers far outrival the splendor of Solomon. The most gorgeous attire produced by the skill of art cannot bear comparison with the natural grace and radiant beauty of the flowers of God's creation. Jesus asked, "If God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith?" Matthew 6, verse 28 and 30. If God, the divine artist, gives to the simple flowers that perish in a day their delicate and varied colors, how much greater care will he have for those who are created in his own image? This lesson of Christ is a rebuke to the anxious thought, the perplexity and doubt of the faithless heart. Step to Christ, page 123.